of it. Hallelujah.
Do you know why you will be loose? Because Jesus wants to use you.
Amen.
You will be loose in Jesus' name.
Wherever you have been tied down, in the name of Jesus, because of the anointing of God that is here, receive liberty in Jesus' name. Anointing is yoke destroyer. Anointing is burden remover. Anointing will make you free. We set you free. We make you to have liberty. Liberty to worship God. Some of you want to worship God. You can't, because there are so many bodies. Your heart is burning. You are tired. You are carrying heavy load of the enemy. But when the anointing comes, that is upon me right now. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Put your right hand upon your head. Say, Jesus, let the virtue flow now. Let your energy touch me. Let every yoke be destroyed now. In Jesus' name.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
Anointing. One of the wonders of anointing is deliverance. You can't be anointed and remain in captivity. No. Anointing will open the gate of the enemy. Into a warlock where you have been tied down to be destroyed. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Say to yourself, I will be lifted up.
Hallelujah.
From every dungeon, I will be lifted up.
In Jesus' name.
Point number two.
Another wonder of anointing, apart from liberty, apart from deliverance, apart from freedom. Another thing that anointing does is to bring increase to your life.
It brings increase to you. It brings prosperity to you.
Anointing. It brings power to make wealth to you. Anointing. It brings understanding. It liberates your mind from the way you used to think. And it brings understanding of what to do. You will know what to do in life to make it.
And I see you making it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the book of Psalms, Psalm 23. Verse 5. Psalm 23, verse 5. Remember we said that thou anointed my head with oil. What happened? My cup runs over. My head was anointed with oil. But the effect of that anointing is my cup. And what is cup? Cup is something you use to drink for your comfort. Cup. Anointing will furnish your table with good things.
Hallelujah. All you need to do is walk the anointing of God over your life. Anointing will open unto you the treasures of darkness. Anointing will cause you to go into the riches of secret places. Anointing, it gives you power to make wealth.
I see you making wealth in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Do you know, sometimes ago the Lord, I was sleeping and the Lord woke me up. He said, congratulate those people in this church. For none of them shall be poor.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anointing for abundance is in the house. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say, I will be rich in
Jesus' name.
I refuse to be poor in Jesus' name.
Anointing removes scarcity, austerity, want. It removes it. It causes your cup to overflow your anointing. You have more than enough money in your pocket, in your life, to do whatever you want to do. Amen.
Amen.
Another wonder of anointing that I want to share with you, that I've shared before, is that anointing brings illumination. Anointing brings understanding. And when you have understanding, your life will become outstanding.
Anointing gives you understanding of what to do in life. In the book of 1 John chapter 2, 1 John chapter 2, verses 26 to 27. 1 John chapter 2, verses 26 to 27, he says that this is the promise that God has for you. That anointing that you have received will teach you all things. You don't need anyone to teach you, because anointing of God within you will begin to teach you. The option you have received is a teacher.
Hallelujah.
It brings illumination, it brings revelation, it brings understanding. It decodes and deciphers for you the secret coded works of the Lord. Anointing.
Amen. You be anointed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And your life will be outstanding in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the book of 1 John chapter 2 verse 20. 1 John chapter 2 verse 20. The Bible says that ye have received an unction from the Holy One. And you know all things. Somebody say, I know all things.
I know all things.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Another wonder of anointing. Point number 4 is anointing brings divine protection. It gives you divine protection. The anointed is the preserved. The anointed ones are the protected ones. Amen.
Yeah.
In the book of Psalm, Psalm 105 verses 12 to 15. Psalm 105 verses 12 to 15. The Bible says, Psalm 105 verses 12 to 15. It says, when there were very few people and stranger in it, when they move from one kingdom to another kingdom, from one nation to another nation, and suffer no man to do them no wrong. He rebuked kings for their sake, saying, touch not my anointed. I do my prophet. No harm. When you are anointed, you become untouchable. Why? Because you become the apple of his hand. Somebody said,
untouchable.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Point number 4 that we have discussed, because I want to go to the point today, that we have discussed before. Another wonder of anointing is anointing brings promotion. You can't be anointed and remain on the floor. Anointing will lift you up. Anointing is the lifter of men. Amen.
Amen.
And promotion is the will of God for you. In the book of Psalms 75, verse 6 and 7. Psalms 75, verses 6 and 7. The Bible says promotion cometh not from the east, not from the west, not from the south, but God is the judge. It's the one that lifts one up and debates another. I see God lifting you up in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And he does that by his anointing. Anointing will pick up a man from the dunghill. We clean him up, we lift him up, and cause him to sit among the kings and the princes of the earth. I will see you at the top in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Anointing brings promotion. Anointing brings elevation. A lie. And I told you of the story of a man called Saul. Saul was a nobody in Israel. The only thing that was noticeable about Saul was his height. Saul was a tall guy. He was any taller than everyone in Israel.
Hallelujah.
But I told you last 2 weeks ago that being tall does not guarantee a place in tall places. Being tall does not guarantee success in life. Physical attribute does not guarantee success. Don't deceive yourself. It's not all tall people that know how to play basketball.
Hallelujah.
I don't know how to play basketball and I'm not ready. Amen. Being tall does not guarantee an automatic placement in the NBA. No! But if you are tall and you have become anointing upon your life, you can't remain on the floor.